All right, let's integrate sine of pi x. And I'm going to take the informal approach first. The informal approach is just recognizing that all we're doing here is the chain rule backwards. So I have the sine of some function. Well, maybe that came from the cosine of that function. But the chain rule would have tacked on a factor of pi, if that's what it came from. So that's how I'm looking at it. So let's just make it look a little more like it came from the chain rule operating on the cosine of pi x. So I can't just throw a pi in there, so I have to divide it out in front. All right, so now that I have the sine of some function sitting next to the derivative of that function, it's a simple guess to figure out the function this came from. The thing I differentiate to get sine is negative cosine of that thing. So I end up with 1 over pi times negative cosine pi x. And I always wait on my plus c until I've cleaned everything up. All right, hopefully you start to do more of this checking mentally just to make sure that you've done it right. But if I check it, all I have to do is differentiate. And the derivative of this thing. And this really helps to solidify your understanding of doing the chain rule forwards and backwards. So I highly encourage you to check answers all the time. And the derivative of the cosine is negative sine pi x. Negative sine pi x. And then the chain rule says now you have to multiply by the derivative of pi x with respect to x, which is just pi. So there's my minus sign, gone. There's my pi, gone, and I get what I started with. I can also perform this integral formally. So I'm going to say let u equal pi x. Well, that means du is pi dx. And I'll go back and look at my integral. I have sine of pi x dx. And I need this to occur in the integral, so I'm going to multiply by pi on the interior and then divide by it on the exterior. Notice it's something we really already did when we took the informal approach. So I have sine pi x times pi dx. And now I can transform in terms of u. So u is just pi x, so I have sine u. Pi dx, that's just du. And that was the whole point of the substitution, was to cook the integral into a form where we could just guess the antiderivative. That's negative cosine u. So I get negative 1 over pi cosine of u, but u is pi x. And then I'll make sure to put my plus c on there. So I get the same answer either way. I'm just always encouraging you to take this informal approach if you happen to see it.